Hey guys, Scorch here. Today we're using the new Doodle Aerostall, which actually goes absolutely crazy, allowing something broken in the game right now to get free entry. Let's hop right into it. So looking at Aerostall, we're going to be running it super bulky, so it's 140 health to start. Running it full bulk, we have health, magic defense. Magic defense just to neutralize these defenses. These equips, just keeping it as bulky as possible. We have floaty here. This is the better trait right now. This allows us to get a +1 on any air move. Which, with things like hit and runs going around, like you can come in on any hit and runner, get a free +1 off those. And I mean, we're super bulky to begin with, so that's great. And yeah, now we are going to be running it as a defensive pivot. So hit and run, crystal cut is just a stab move. There wasn't really a fourth move it needed. Heal shifting with removal. This does have things like Sylphid or Crit Up, but I just didn't really see a synergy that worked well with this. Just because it's like 80 speed to start, so it's hard to like underspeed stuff, especially with like Sylphids up. So it just, it's difficult to do that. So yeah, just running it as a defensive pivot, which is going to be great because it allows us to give entry on this thing. So Gargoyle. This thing recently got a huge buff with Dauntless, so this allows it to do 50% more magical damage. If it has a status, it's basically what Renute does, except it's better because one, it does more damage than Renute does. It has 113 magic attack to start. It's also 126 speed. So even with these speed equips, we outspeed a majority of the game. Plus, we hit super hard. It also has a signature move which inflicts curse on stuff. So we have a guaranteed curse on anything we click this on, which turns Hex into 120 base power. Plus, we cut magic attacks. And aerial as a air stab move, and then hit and run as the last move. This could be fatal flaw, but I didn't see a reason to run fatal flaw for like one thing. And like with hit and run, we can click this comfortably, so we don't like lose momentum or something. So if we know they're probably gonna switch out, boom, we click hit and run. We still do damage. We also have a little bit of physical attack. We still do damage and pivot off of them and keep our momentum. And then, yeah, the other four things basically just complement the team. We also have this as a second pivot, just because this, I forgot to mention, this only has three weaknesses, being ice, mind, and metal. So this can pivot off of the ice, mind, and metals. And yeah, let's see if I can prove that pairing Aerostall with Gargoyle is absolutely broken. Okay, looking at this battle, that's an ice type, I believe. So this is going to be an issue for this. But I mean, it's fine. We have bubble, there's no issues whatsoever. Looking at this game, that's a defensive one. That's a beast type. I mean, this goes crazy. There's not a single light type. Yeah, no, literally everything gets absolutely nuked by this. I don't really want to lead it because like Metal Elytra is probably coming out. I'm gonna lead this for Metal Elytra. Also fine for this. Also fine for this. This as well. The only thing is if this leads, but I think it's fast as well, which we have bubble, so actually no, we need to be awakened for this. This is ice earth, right? I might lead this just because wait, this is called Scar Fox or something, right? Yeah, it's 125 speed. Okay, we're leading bubble. I'm scared of this. It does end up being Metal Elytra, but I mean it's fine. This is not the end of the world. All right, anyways, I mean this is also fine. We just click earthquake, right? There's no drawbacks to this. So Gargoyle can probably just, well, it obviously nukes everything, outspeed everything. It doesn't outspeed Scar Fox if it's speed invested enough. It's like 120, like it's up there with it. So there's a possibility of it outspeeding. It has a cone of cold. It has, it's got moves. But anyways, here we did. This is defensive for sure. I don't know what they do though, so I'm just gonna click Earthquake again. Yeah, the hit and run comes out. They have no immunities. They're probably gonna go like Hypnotal, which is fine because yeah, we go Umeshu. There is. Yeah, no, this is weak to mind, so we can't really go into this. Actually, go into this thing. So, the seal, it's basic water, and it doesn't have, it does nothing, I don't think. I'm just gonna go this and pivot. Aerostall comes in, we get to pivot off of this, and then probably just go into Gargoyle and just nuke something. I don't see any reason not to. Yeah, this, I mean, okay, they get their health back, but, like, your momentum's gone. Or, well, not gone, but we get momentum, so. Yeah, we'll hit run. We actually move first. Wait, hold up. What's the speed on this thing? 50. Oops. Okay, well, I mean, we have Junipero. It's not like at the end of the world. It's not. Well, we also have this. Wait, what's 69, 80? Yeah, this is way less speedy. We're also immune to water move. So we'll go into this and pivot. In this situation, yeah, oh, the disarm too. I mean, we'd rather this disarmed than the lethal on this, so that's fine. You know, I guess in that situation, Umeshu is better just because it is lower, but I mean, this has way less bulk than this, so, and no removal, so, and of worse typing. So it's like, whatever. This works. Both took like no health regardless. We get our momentum no matter what. I also realized this could have came in on a hit and run. It still gets that, right? No, I think it got changed. Wait, what is Hypnotal's? No, that was Morvel that got. Okay, I don't know. We'll, Ice Tea. So this is the fox thing that I was afraid of. But our bubble's awakened. It's immune to ice type moves, so we just go into it. Also, we could have Shifting Winds, and I don't know why I didn't. With the Aerostol, we could have Shifting Winds on the, on, well, it was this, but I just wanted the free momentum, I'll be honest. I was so focused on that. Anyways. Tidal Slam switch-ins include Hypnotal, include Dame Seal. I'll just Tidal Slam, I don't know. We'll get damage on, what is this? Metal Elytra, we miss. Okay. I mean, this was a roll to kill, probably, unless this was like a high roll, but I mean, it is what it is. We, I mean, what moves? They're gonna have Shifting Beast Summon, Hit and Run, and Disarm, I think. I'm just gonna hit this, I don't know. Antenna Beam, oh, it has a move, okay. 1%, crazy. It's fine, we can, I don't even know. I mean, this can, on the spiky thorns, plus the antenna beam is nothing to us anyways, plus we can, like, set up pylons on this, so. Yeah, we'll go into this. This is also their Shifting Winds user, I think, so. Shock Therapy. I just realized that they're immune to their conductor. I just forgot. Wait. Wait, we're literally throwing. This is conductor. Actually, guys, this was, oh, they switch out. Never mind. Okay. Scorch Senior comes in. Scorch Senior, the female, right? All right, we see the sumo, which not a good thing for this, but it doesn't really matter. Here we go into Aerostol for free. We get the free pivot off of it. Although it is slower than us because it's 40 speed. That's the only thing. Which, yeah, it's fine. Incinerate. I mean, we can't really stop that, right? I guess we could have went this, but I was scared of the burning orb, so. I didn't really say that out loud, but, you know, I don't want to get burned. Well, Shifting Winds, we're faster anyways. We'll get rid of those Bee Summon. That Bee Summon. And, yeah, I mean, now they go into, like, Hypnotal. Now we get Umeshu in, and we, like, pivot, so. Actually, they probably go Scar Fox. I don't know what Scar Fox does, but I just know it's an ice type, so I'm just afraid of it. But I mean, even if they go into it, we're immune to the ground move and the ice move, you know, we have this. So they're kind of in a sticky situation with Scarfox. But here, I don't think this, what does this do? Wait, what is this even called? Flong. That doesn't even sound like a doodle name. What? Beast type. All right, well, let's take a look at this. I know it has, like, dark moves, but dark, it has Rest, it has Venom Bite, Iron Slash. Okay, it's probably going to Iron Slash, I assume, is what they're doing here. This can just come in. Like, set up on it and just go crazy. That is not an Iron Slash. I don't know what that is, but it's resisted, so. And that did a lot. I'll be honest, it did a lot. Flung is 78 speed. We are faster than it. They probably just go into Sumo every time. So, I mean, we need to get entry on this and just start doing stuff, right? I'm gonna go Bubble. I'm predicting the Sumo coming. I'm going Bubble. Yes, wait. Does that mean they're faster than us? Okay, wait. They switched out first, but I believe that means we're fa they're faster than Junipero. So, emeralds? Maybe? Is that bold of me to guess? I feel like that. I think that's emeralds, because the switch thing for them went first, and usually it's based on speed, isn't it? I'm not crazy, right? All right, we're gonna Tidal Slam because I don't jetpack in case they stay in. And I mean, this is yeah, it's fine. Guilt, maybe we should have Earthquaked. I mean, they're gonna click the healing move anyways, right? So, honestly, what is this doing to us? Do we not break through this? Toughen, but they switch into the this. I mean, we're plus one. That move they had was physical, right? It had like gnaw or something in the name. Physical 130 base. That was 130 base power. What the heck? I mean, we live, but yeah. Okay, that has bulk. Wait, I thought that killed. Wait, what? 111 health. Oops. Oopsies. Well, it's fine. They're locked into that move, which doesn't exactly do anything. That literally doesn't help us. This is a little scary because bubble's slightly low, but as long as it's alive, then they still can't click their ice move comfortably. Now, Montour is important for. What is it important for? I mean, this is weak to this, weak to this. I might just go Montour. I was gonna say we can go into this, but I don't want to get it too low, because this is gonna do a lot. It's 130, and yeah, look at the damage. That just speaks for itself. And we get the para, nice. So I'm pretty sure this is Emerald. We got the para on it, which I mean, you know, that's cool. And did they get rid of pylons? I blanked out. Wait, did they get rid of? I think they did. Because they had Metalytra. I'm pretty sure pylons aren't up. Yeah, okay, good. I didn't. Alright, and it's not Emerald. Wait, what? Is this just a fast set? I'm pretty sure that's just a really fast set. Which, I mean, it's fine. We can, like, resist this and, you know, work around it. But watch them click gnaw right now. No, they get the burn. There's no way they just did. Okay, well, it's fine. It's not the end of the world. We can show off, yeah, Aerostall when it's still. Oh, wait, but we don't get. I completely forgot that the Thor. I'm throwing. I'm just being dumb. I'm gonna go this and just sack it. I saw the damage, like, oh, we're gonna get Thorns to put this, but. Ha, there we go. See? Besides the burn, it paid off because they're both technically alive. I don't know what I'm doing. It doesn't really matter. Ice-T comes in. Now, this is a ground type. And it's probably clicking a ground move right now. But, I mean, what are we doing, right? We just sack it. Landslide. That'd be funny if they missed. Okay, so. Gargoyle. Okay, Scarfox is 125. So they're one base speed point below us. They're gonna be scared regardless. Like. Say they, I don't know, some crazy scenario, they're Emerald with 125 speed. Obviously, they're locked into Landslide. So, I mean, equipment-wise, they're never outspeeding us. So I feel like they're gonna, like, we're basically bluffing right now, right? Because they're scared of us killing them. And, yeah, like, they're scared of us being faster and killing them. I'm clicking this because this is always coming in, yeah. So that's cool. We didn't get the burn. We don't have the burn yet. So, yeah, now we kill them for sure. Perfect. So we break Dame Seal. And, wait, did we not just win? Wait, we literally just win. Wait, hold up. Wait, we can literally just win. They do actually, this might live one because it's sumo. But other than that, like, we literally go Aerostall and pivot in. Like, yeah, this literally is just GG's right now. They can't do anything to this. Like they think I know it's not. I'm sure it's not, but they think their Scarfox is slower than us, because we like bluffed it there. So Yeah. And I mean, we also have this still alive to come in an ice move, so it's not like they can comfortably click an ice move, right? Plus, this can pivot still, this can pivot still. Junipero still exists, although, I mean, that's an ice type, so, like, you know. But, yeah, this thing is weak to, you know, but I'm just gonna calc. I'm pretty sure it just dies. Guaranteed Oko with. Yeah, it dies. This is deleted. I use my set from draft, and it's like feeder rock pizza, so yeah. Deleted. We also have the pylons chip, so. Yeah, I mean, Gargoyle just wins now. There's literally nothing they can do. Sumo comes in. Now we can go into Aerostall and do the thing, but yeah, no, other than this, it's like, yeah, they literally can't do anything. Actually, we can't even. This is gonna be a sack because the sumo's faster, I forgot, but. Actually, we can literally heal if we want to, but we're not. But we could. Wait, we can literally get this healthy. There's not even a point to going into this because they're faster, but. Yeah, I mean. They tried to take out on their own mushroom. Okay, nice. I mean, this wasn't the perfect match for Aerostall. I mean, obviously, like stuff like Sumo existing, we don't underspeed that. And it did get burned, and there wasn't, like, there was a fast ice type, there was a mine type, but, like, you know, it still showed what it did. Basically, like, this helps it get Venusaur, but, like, these two, Mantar helps as well because of the fast physical things, but basically, we just feed into Gargoyle, and it just goes absolutely crazy. Like, we literally just win. Like, the next time we get entry and it's not in front of Sumo with this thing, we literally just win the game. I'm gonna hit and run. They. Okay, we're just given the pivot. The one time they switch out. Perfect. All right. Well, I mean, we hit and run. Oh, wait, what am I doing? They literally. We. I thought it was this. Oops. It doesn't matter. We pivot now. We pivot now. They get health, but they're still gonna die to Gargoyle, so. Yeah, actually, we should go into Junipero because. They might be faster. There's no chance they are, but they might. They might. Actually, no, what am I doing? Now they go into sumo. Let's just show the end of the battle. We're gonna win this. Gargoyle gets three kills if I make the right plays. But yeah, let's go to the end and let's hop into the next battle. Okay, looking at this team, ghost resists. I mean, this could be an issue. But, I mean, we have Aerial. We can also just pivot off of it. So, this is fine. We also have Bubble and Junipero, I guess, as well. But, match for Aerostall. I mean, weaknesses include there's no ice types, there's no mine types. And there's one metal type. So, I mean, we can pretty much pivot off of majority of this game with Aerostall, get this entry. And then, I mean, leads. What do we want to lead here? We could see. I mean, Vigilante, this. I don't really know what this does, but it's like quad weak to fire. I would think we can just lead. Well, no, we don't want to lead that because we want to get our burn. So, we'll lead. I don't know, neglect Vigilante entry, so I don't know, I guess we can lead. Well, this is weak. I'll just lead this. We'll lead this. Seer comes out first. We have Infernius. Okay, that's fine. That's a terrible lead for us, but I mean, we don't really lose anything. We can just. I mean, I don't really want to get this burned, so I'll go into. Do I want this? Yeah, no, we have to go this. We'll go into Aerostall right off the bat. It'll take nothing. We can pivot off of this for free. Even if they burn this, I mean, we'd rather this burned, right? Yeah, no, look at the damage. That was nice. So, I don't think the play was ever to lead this. I was just, I don't know. I wanted to counter lead Vigilante. I didn't really know. I guess we had Bubble, which could chunk. This is weak too, and I guess this, but I don't know. It's fine. This worked out. We can hit run, pivot off of this. And yeah, hopefully get Gargool. I mean, we literally can get Gargool. There's nothing they can do. This is the only issue Gargool has as well. Other than that, we can just spam our signature move. Okay, we see. What's this? I don't even know. Mewsula, which is weak to hit and run, so that's cool. Comes in. It's beast food. I'm pretty sure it just dies to this, right? What's. No, it's insect food. What am I saying? No, it's quad weak to beast. And it's quad weak to fire as well. So Aerial just nukes it. No, Aerial 100% nukes it. We can actually hit and run here. Just because they're probably going to switch out, right? Like, what world do they stay in and, you know, just let this die, right? So we can hit and run, get momentum, or we just kill it, which, I mean, they're never staying in. But just in case they stay in, we do just get the kill regardless. Furnace ship? No, Volt comes in. So I was going to say fishing for electrocute, but we're burned, so yeah. And then, I mean, here we can go. What do we go even? Obviously, well. I mean, we could get, like, pylons up. They don't touch this whatsoever. Yeah, we'll go this and get pylons up. They're forced to hit and run. And, I mean, if they hit and run, they get Thorns Chip. Plus, yeah, it's free pylon setting. So we might as well go into this. Get pylons up. And yeah, I mean, what is the removal? Does this have like shifting winds or something? Okay, we see this come back on the field. I know this has like all the slashing moves or something. How do you spell this? It's got. What does this do again? The signature move makes us food type, and then we're weak to like crunch and swarm. I mean, they're bug, so can't go Meishu, obviously. I mean, we have this. I think we could just go straight into this, right? Or we could. Do they have a mind? No. Do they have an ice move? Maybe. What's the speed? 75. We can just go into this and pivot off. If they be make us a food type, we can just go into Junipara the next turn. Honey Slap, that's fine. Literally fine. We just go this now, and they're gonna wanna click the bug move, which, you know, is fine. So we'll go into this. And then we can actually quick thinking on the switch out, so this is perfect. This is like. Yeah, no, I'm completely fine with this. Oh, then let's do it again, which I mean, it's not gonna. Yeah. That's fine. No, that's literally fine. They're quad weak to fire. We're faster. Oh, wait. Yeah. Okay. I was gonna say, wait, what? They're not? How? You know, they're quad weak to fire, so. I mean, we set up and then we go nuts, basically. Like, they go Infernius, but it's neutral. We're doing this. Yeah, here's Infernius. This is like the number one issue for our Gargoyle. So, like, trading that. I mean, it's not even a trade. We're literally. Like, what are they doing to us? We're neutral to fire. We're weak to earth, though, aren't we? No, we're neutral to earth because plant. Yeah, no, we're. This is completely fine. We could even set up again, but again, is there a point? Not really. Actually, maybe. I mean, they have a. Mon or not Montour, Seraphine, which is neutral as well, and again, like, is neutral to us, so or hits us neutrally. Yeah, no, we definitely do not need a plus two. That does a lot. What the heck? Fireball? Oh, wait, fire does. Wait, what? Oh, wait, we're still food type. Wait, I forgot. Wait. Okay, well, it's fine. Wait, no, it's fine. I completely forgot we're still food type. Okay, well, that's not good. It's fine. No, we're fine. We still broke the Infernius. That's all that matters here. This is dead for sure. So, Yeah, I blanked. You guys are probably screaming at me watching that, but it's fine. No, it's completely fine. Junipero's purpose this game was literally just to break this, because everything else just dies to this basically. This, I guess, Junipero could help with, but it's not exactly needed. This could have a Rip Current. I don't really want to take that. So, I mean, it has days, but do we really care? I'll go this on the wave shot. Okay. I mean, we could just set it again, technically. I mean, why don't we, right? They're gonna daze. Oh no, they don't have daze, or they just didn't want to click it. I mean, why would you risk that, to be honest? Okay, we see this come back in with a sickly sweet. Now, it is full health, which is a little bit annoying, but yeah. They're gonna make this. We need to get Gargoyle entry, and we can't really go into Aristotle or Amashu, because we just become. Well, this already is a food type, but it just, like, forces us to be a food type, and then it hits us with Swarm, so. Kind of irritating. I mean, we have. This is 120 health? Okay, maybe this. Hold up, this might be an issue. There's no point hitting it. Actually, they're gonna. Is Honey Slap? Slap. It's a slap. It's gonna be contact. We're gonna hit this. That does nothing. But I mean, Thorns Chip. That's not contact. Wait, a move that has the word slap and it is non. Okay, never mind. Alright, well. I mean, we have Bubble. Which. I mean, we probably can go into it, to be honest. This might. What do we even need? Jingle. Okay. Do we need Omeishu necessarily? I guess for Vigimax. No, for Vigimax for sure. Rugal Bubble, I guess. They're not gonna Honey Slap again, right? They always click the. Yeah, there's a swarm. Perfect. Okay, there we go. That's how we work around it. So, obviously it's food, so it's weak to water, and we're water type, so that's cool. Now, actually, we just get a kill now. They don't do anything to this. This is honestly really annoying to deal with, because we lost Juni, because I just didn't. I just blanked on the fact that we were food. I guess you can't really, but I wish there was like a visual or something, because. Yeah, I don't know, it just. I don't even know how you could do that. Make it a status? That's weird. No. I just completely forgot about that. Here, I could have probably read this, but I mean, we go Mantra every time, so. This is fine. Do not date. Yeah, they always. They always, wait. Oh, yeah, we did click it earlier. Okay, we heal here. There's the daze. Alright, well, I mean, they eventually. Well, they do lose, so. Nice! I was gonna say, we're eventually gonna get that, but wait, we don't heal back enough, but then we get it first try. Well, that's cool. Now, I mean, we can literally do this. Just to be safe. And then, yeah, we keep Amashu healthy for this. And, other, like, this is low enough where it just dies to an aerial. Actually, what is this? Oh, okay. Wait, what? Alright. I mean. Are they gonna swarm here? I'd rather just. I'm gonna click this. They honey slap, perfect, okay. I was gonna say this, they're not gonna swarm, because we can just go into bubble, right? And that's exactly okay. Now we go this for free. Okay, here we go. Here's the momentum we need. This is. Yeah, this is perfect. So now literally everything dies to an aerial. There's nothing they can do right now. Absolutely everything dies. We hit run actually because, yes, momentum if they go like Volt. Which, actually, we kill Volt too. I should have just clicked that. No, I literally just should have clicked that. I guess Seraphine. No, they're gonna sack Seraphine. So, oh no, they go Jinglark. Alright. That's unexpected. I mean, it doesn't really matter. We can go into this. I mean, this gets to heal, actually. I should have just aerialed. We literally killed everything. Oh, it's boomerang. Okay. Alright, that shows after. I didn't even know that. Oh my gosh, this thing. Bruh. Honey slap incoming. Now. Honestly. What do we necessarily need this for? Seraphim's basically dead. Jinglark is always revenge killed by this. I'm setting pylons. I'm fine with dying to this. Honey slap? That's fine. Kill me. Kill me? We get gargoyle entry, and then we click aerial, and then we literally just kill something. So, yeah, I'm completely fine with this. Watch them go volt or something. Actually, if they go volt, they just give us shock therapy, so. Watch the 10% para. Nah. Alright. Now we go gargoyle, and now we just kill everything on the field, basically. There's nothing they can do here. Not the best game for Aerostol, just because of the fact that, you know, this turns the things into food types, and then it just hits them super effectively. So, yeah, that's the only thing. Like, obviously it has three weaknesses, great, but there's also this that just, you know, does that. Which, I mean, we can still bring it in. We haven't seen that yet, which we probably will end up seeing this game. But, obviously, it's not ideal, so. Yeah. This game would have been a lot quicker if we didn't take that hit. Like, if Junipara was still alive. Like, I would have been chill with going Aerostol. Pivoting into Juni, and then, like, the issue was that. Yeah, this died, so we didn't have a proper force up to this, besides this, which, you know, it doesn't take any hit whatsoever, so it can't exactly come in. Although, food, yeah, Ghost does resist food. We could probably take one, but obviously it's not ideal. We're taking chip from Burns, and if we get this low when, you know, we have two moves left to click, then obviously we're not gonna want to do that. Okay, so Voltatu here is, how much is this taking? This takes a lot. We need it like this much chip and it's dead. We do, no, we'll go this because we want a Meishu healthy for Vigilante, although it does resist electric. It's just gonna hit run, so yeah, perfect. There's a defense boost, so yeah, no, this is good. No, this is actually good. We can heal, most likely. Because what's coming in and just forcing this out? They have nothing to hit this super effectively. Here's yeah, no, here, we're going to show Aerostol here a lot better. Because how do they force this out, right? We're plus one. We're 140 health. Jinglark comes in. Now, I think we can heal on this and then hit run on it. I don't see a reason we can't. Shifting winds, they're just getting rid of the hazards. Which, yeah, we can't set up again, but it's fine. This is healthy, so now we can bring this in on Mule-Ursa. Where does the M-I-E words come from? This is like, Ursa's like bear, but is Mule like, alright. But yeah, no, we just, yeah, momentum's free here. We're full health. Vines go up. Alright, well, we're going to be using this a lot, Mark, so we need to get rid of those vines. But we just go into this. Air types are immune, right? They have to be. Yeah, okay. I was scared for a second. Wait, did I just throw? No, we're good. Okay, here we go. We're going to click the signature move here. It's safe. Whatever comes in. Oh, wait, what? Huh? Wait, is that priority or something? What does Tempest do? I'm sorry, what? Does this have priority? It's 40 base, is this 40 base power? It clears, the user whips up a storm intending to clear the skies of all weather. Wait, how did that go first? Are we, there's no way we're slower than that. Jinglark is like 100. It's literally impossible for them to outspeed it. Oh, unless it's M, no, it can't be. Oh, it's 112. Okay, wait, maybe with Nimble, not Nimble, sorry, plus speed. And then max speed. Yeah, no, it outspeeds us at max speed. They literally have to be max. If they're max speed, they outspeed us by 1 point. Wait, I didn't even consider this, but maybe it's worth... Okay, maybe I should adjust my set slightly just because of that one thing. I just... this 112 max speeds outspeed us by 1 point. This is intended to just outspeed 110 max speeds, because I thought that's all we needed, but I guess this is pretty irrelevant, to be honest. Maybe that's not the case, but... Yeah, I mean... We don't even care. No, entangling vines. I don't know why they said entangling vines, because it's literally useless. This wants to be vines. This wants to be vines. This doesn't really care. This is immune to vines, so... I mean, that's fine by me. We'll go this. We'll just continue pivoting. Like, this doesn't touch this. And, yeah, I mean, once we get this entry, then... Yeah, they're gonna hit run. We're always slower, but it also helped with the vines. And yeah, once this comes in. And we go Gargoyle, and then we click Aerial, and Infernius takes a handful. So yeah, this is this is perfect. And I mean, if Infernius doesn't die in 2, we just go into Aristol again, so... Yeah, let me get momentum. We don't even need a Shifting Winds, because again, the Vines is a good thing. And yeah, I don't see a way they can come back from this, because Vigimante there, we have Umeshu, decently healthy. We have this, which is faster. Unless it's never going to be fast enough. Like, we're fast enough for sure. And then... Yeah, there's also in this right here, so... Okay, that's enough. This dies. There's no... Wait, I'll calc it to be sure, but... Let's go... Health, magic, defense... Pizza? I don't know. 57, yeah, it definitely dies. Perfect. And then Infernius comes in, we go Aristol, and yeah, it's not the most exciting battle, just because of the fact that Junipyro was, I'll be honest, it was thrown. I just made a bad play, I didn't know it was, or I just forgot about the fact that it was, you know, slower, but, or sorry, not slower, food type. I was thinking slower, because it's this slower than this, but, you know, because this is a food type because of the thing, but it's fine. Here, I did say they probably don't outspeed us, but the fact that they went into this rather than Infernius makes me think they're confident in how fast they are, so they might actually be, like, max speed or something? I don't know. Like, I don't know why they went into this, but we'll go into Umeshu here. I don't know. Like... They never click a water move. They click Icy Punch. Yeah. That's the best they have, and it did that much. So yeah, we could even feast this, but I'm just going to take out and get momentum, because I don't want to be here for 20 hours. Yeah. Here comes Infernius. There's that. And then... Yeah, now Bubble comes in and just nukes something. Please don't give me... They did, but it doesn't matter. Actually, this is kind of good, because now they can't burn us. This is actually completely fine. Tidal Slam still is a lot to Vigimante, so we're going to take it. Aurora Flash, don't miss. Okay, we're good. Perfect. Okay, well, I mean, Gargoyle probably cleans, unless this is faster. If it's faster, we have a Umeshu. We have Aristol. And, yeah, it looks like it's going to be a GG's here. We sack this because there's vines up, so we're never going to do anything to this anyways. We're vulnerable, which... Actually, we could... No, it's like 120 attack. No, there's no way. They Fin Slash, they kill this. We can... I mean, we just go on Umeshu and Feast, to be honest. Like, oh, they dark... Oh, okay. All right, got it. I mean, I'll take it, I guess. Yeah, no, I'm gonna speed up the battle here. This is gonna just be, yeah, Gargoyle Sweep. We go, hey, we'll go Aristal just because it's the showcase, and I mean, either one does the job. This does it better because it's resisted, but it's fine, or it's immune to water. I mean, but yeah, no, we'll pivot off of this, and then Gargoyle's gonna sweep here. It's gonna be GG's, and the chat's broken. Nice. Oh, the Vigilante was Emerald. That's what it was. So it was non-awakened an Emerald. So, yeah. Anyways, Aristotle cleans it up. It's gonna be GG's. There's a super effective hit, so that's cool. Plus one, super effective, coming from a Vigilante. Perfect. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. I'm gonna be streaming the release of Tales of Tanara tomorrow, so if you're interested in that, I look forward to seeing you there. Until next time. Scorch out.